This is not a game.
Go beat it. Go beat it.
This Southern hospitality got out of hand.
It's always a homicide on Central Drive.
Chinese hood.
Yeah.
In the forest.
Lots of ladies out here. You don't want to bother. Leave them alone.
They say that they famous sauce.
One of the biggest shells in the Southeast.
That's where the KKK started it.
Are these the water guys?
Two blitz. Like.
MLK was born here. Hats off to MLK.
We out here hustling. We out here making shit happen.
You got to have a different type of eye to really be able to see what's really going on.
Got that boy Peter on the block. They want to talk him out.
Or your immune system and bad anxiety. I'd have been shot in my stomach, so you know.
Those were slave homes.
America to me like the Matrix.
You can't avoid it, you just gotta keep living.
Tell me about Gold Teeth.
The best place to eat in the city, man.
And whatever you're doing, keep being consistent, keep doing your thing, bro.
Officer says no.
The reason why everybody love Atlanta, the reason why this is the most popular place on the planet.
We gonna get you in there.
Please. All right, I just met up with Kodak here. In Atlanta, and he said, I gotta wear these shades.
Yeah,
is that working?
Yeah, you in
okay.
there.
We have the great privilege to meet with Kodak because he knows the hoods well in the city, also knows the history really well.
This is not a game. You finna get the rawest history you about to ever get on any platform right now.
I like
now,
raw. You know, let's go ahead. Gutter, you're the chauffeur.
I guess so.
We're gonna talk about some the good shit about Atlanta, you know what I mean? The reason why everybody love Atlanta, the reason why this is the most popular place on the planet.
So guys, what I'm gathering here is it's like sort of countryside. It's not like really super urban here.
Georgia in general, it's good country now, you know what I'm saying? We got a city, but you know, get a little country out here.
You're country folk. You consider yourself, are you doing some farming?
I ain't did no farming now, I ain't gonna say that.
I know nothing about Atlanta, I'll be honest. I know zero other than 2 days of being here.
So this is our first time?
Got a lot going on, yeah, total virgin.
What?
Yeah.
Well, look, man, welcome.
You're popping my cherry.
Welcome to
So what's going on out here? Are people moving into the neighborhood or are they moving out?
It's cool. Yeah, like the Southern hospitality got out of hand. Like, we cool, you know what I'm saying? But it be like, damn, you know, much as I love for people to experience Atlanta, I'm sorry, man. Give us a break.
It's always a homicide. It's always a homicide on Central Drive.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Been a lot lately or no?
Oh, all the time.
All the time. Yeah. How are things right now? How's the frequency? Is it getting hotter or cooler or what?
It's medium range right now.
Medium hot.
Yeah.
But this is a historical place.
Yeah, going Central. Down the hill to the Chevron, you'll see real action down there. And you see a whole bunch of people outside.
You from here?
No, I'm from Ohio.
What do you think of Atlanta?
I love it.
Why?
The heat. The weather and the women all day.
Better than Ohio ladies.
Oh yeah. They easier down here. You got them uppity girls in Ohio.
I agree. You know, Atlanta got a lot of ladies, man. Over there, right across the street, little Chinatown.
Chinatown where, in the forest?
You can't see it, but yeah, little Chinatown is actually behind the forest.
They're Chinese people or you just call it there?
Yeah.
So it's Chinese hood.
Yeah, it's like a little gritty little hood over there called Chinatown.
Can we check it out?
You want to see Chinatown?
I can speak a little Chinese.
All right, I'll walk you through Chinatown. Come on, we'll walk over.
We're walking to Chinatown.
Yeah, we can't ride it.
You got me on a little bit of a mysterious journey.
Look, you can't just.
I'm looking down here. I'm seeing like countryside Vermont.
That's what you something. Feel.
Look at this guy and his bike.
It's like safe for now because you really wouldn't even know about this little area over here.
Right. It's right behind the trees. I didn't see it.
Exactly. We call it a little Chinatown, but of course it's going to have black folks who live over here too. You know what I'm saying? We everywhere through goddamn Atlanta, so we everywhere through Stone Mountain too. So Stone Mountain is where the KKK started it.
Really?
Yeah.
In this area right around here?
Yeah, like the mountain is actually like that one.
You got some rough history around here.
Yeah, we got Native American history. Shermantown got big history. They had a war in Shermantown.
Mm-hmm.
In general, you know what I'm saying? Like, this would be an area where a lot of black folks had to go through a lot of hardship because of the fact of, like, racism. Growing up here, I would see on top of Stone Mountain, like, KKK poster. You know what I'm saying?
Really?
Like, on the side.
How many years ago?
I was in second grade, so.
Would you see that stuff now anywhere?
Well, no, because they did take it down. But I mean, I still say they got it because the poor people that's on side of the mountain, you know, are some of the people that was a part of, you know, the KKK. So,
wow.
You know, that's just a part of the history.
I can't take you all through the belly of the beast of goddamn Central Jive. This is out of respect for the people, you know what I mean?
What's the belly of the beast all about?
I mean, it ain't nothing bad. It's just active.
There's certain times in the day it's active?
Yeah, of course, you know? I mean, certain things have reached a level where it's hot.
So right now, do you feel like you would need to watch your back at all or not really?
We good, because, you know, Atlanta just one of them places, like, good to the area, but they're going to be good to you, you know?
This is your guy's home turf, basically?
Yeah. Hey.
Yo.
Go inside real quick. Let me talk to the young folks real quick.
Okay.
I see how young he was looking already.
Okay. Right. Doesn't help I look like a cop. Where are you from?
I'm from East Oakland.
What do you think of Atlanta?
Atlanta cool, it's a good spot. You can make money out here. You come out here and they see you out here, hey, what you doing, little bro?
Yeah.
Oh, you selling a little, you trying to get some? Oh, you getting some money? All right, good, come on. Niggas trying to get money out here. Niggas ain't trying to be on none of that fake ass pulling up on a nigga.
Yeah.
What set you, where you from? Man, yeah. All that weird so, ass.
It's weird. Less attitude here. Where's more dangerous, here or East Oakland?
East Oakland, I ain't gonna lie.
This looks way nicer, I gotta say.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like it's like countryside out here.
The 6 months I've been out here, it had been like 4 or 5 murders on this street right here.
How do you avoid it all?
You can't avoid it, you just gotta keep living. Lil Red? Yeah.
This is your rap, yeah?
It's my rap right here. Lil Red, 2020, I sure gotta tune in.
Where do you think the music scene is better? Atlanta or West Coast?
The West Coast shit is like, people only listen to it for a gang perspective. Like out here, they looking for music. Like, you feel me? They making quality music. Out there, they looking for a gang perspective. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Yeah, they looking like.
Is there more gang activity out there or here? Or tough to say?
That's everywhere for real.
Yeah.
That's everywhere out here. It's like different type of shit that you don't see growing up in the West Coast, different out here. Like out here, like on the East Coast side, right? How you got the GDs and the BDs and shit. You don't got none of that shit where I'm from.
GDs or meaties, what are those?
Like, Gangster Disciple.
Is it like Bloods and Crips?
I don't even know. See, where I'm from, I don't even got Bloods and Crips.
That's old school. That's my generation.
Yeah, you gotta go to Sacramento to get that shit. You feel me? I'm from Oakland. We don't got none of that. We got like, you feel me? We make our own shit. It's my partners. Like, I done grew up with these niggas since kids, and we made our own shit. And we the only ones know about it. It ain't like no organization. They've been from the 60s or the 50s, and we jumping in it. Nah, we ain't programming like that.
Are these the water guys?
They got some out here. They everywhere. Look, but they probably not gonna be as aggressive.
Yeah, so you gotta go a little further down to them. They doing good. I respect the hustle.
He think you the police.
Yeah.
Or
so Atlanta has a lot of hustle, right?
A lot of hustle.
That's what you guys are saying.
Yeah.
How you doing, man? Ice cold.
Yeah.
Go ahead, put on, little bro. Rep your shit for the YouTube real quick, man.
Fuck going, man. My name is Lil J.
I just bought one from little bro.
Dang, you'll blame me too.
I'm gonna be fuck with the YouTube. Twin, fuck with the YouTube, man. Fuck with the YouTube.
With YouTube, twin.
I'm gonna be peeing all day, man.
Off your shit, bit,
bro. Oh yeah, y'all need to know. Y'all subscribe to YouTube, man. We just trying to get it on the block.
He's my marketer. Man. Subscribe to my channel. I never say that. How many do you sell a day? How many waters do you sell a day?
Two blips.
Like.
Two blips. Okay, security.
Yeah, we get like 150 that day. You know what I'm saying?
We just trying to protect ourselves, though, because folk be coming, feel me?
But we just trying to stay out of trouble, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
stop playing, get money, though.
Sure. Keep putting on, man. Respect to y'all,
boy.
You feel me? Keep putting on, man.
So that guy had 2 guns on him, huh?
You see how you wouldn't even, like I said, you wouldn't even think that.
You wouldn't even know. Everyone carries out here?
And they just passed a law that you can conceal carry with no permit, so you know, it's about to get real hot.
Is it dangerous for a kid like that not to have a gun because he doesn't have protection? I've been told that before in other neighborhoods.
Possibly. I mean, yeah, to me, possibly. He's still trying to hustle, but what if somebody see him? It's the wrong day or whatever it be.
Yeah.
He's probably staying right here in Extended Stay Hotel.
Yeah.
Growing up, he got to hustle. He got to do something.
Mm-hmm.
That bill got to get paid. He ain't in school. Well, school out now. But.
So he's paying he's getting $150 a day with waters. And then he's got to buy his water, probably less. Yeah, so $100 a day, maybe. And that's not going to be too cheap these days.
Mm-hmm. You already know how
so
that
again,
goes.
Now with gentrification coming to effect, you know, things not being as cheap, you know what I'm saying? So we're going to have more hustle. We're going to have more things that's going on that ain't going to be what people would normally do.
You know? So more financial pressure means more crime too, would you say?
I think fair to say? 110%. 110%. It's like you're muscling the people out. So it's like, what are they gonna do? What are they gonna result to in order for them to feed their family? In order for them to pay their rent? I feel like what makes a place a hood is really the government snatching everything as far as like the basic necessities of what anybody's supposed to have away. And then you can't expect them to be like outstanding citizens when they have to do what they gotta do to survive.
You think they have like solid family life at home?
I mean, it could. You never really know. I've met people that have had, you know, single parent household and had mom and dad, and it's still the same outcome. So, you know, at the end of the day, it got a lot to do with, like, you know, sometimes the area. You know, sometimes people just product of their environment.
One of the biggest jails in the Southeast?
Yes.
One of the biggest in the Southeast.
Southeast.
Of the United States, I believe. One of the biggest. In the house.
Sure. It's where you don't want to end up, huh?
That's right. Yeah.
Is it pretty hardcore in there? Have you heard any stories? Or?
I mean, stuff going on. I ain't gonna say it's super hardcore, but I mean, it's jail, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
Playing the game, to me, is like, you know you gotta work, you know you gotta hustle to survive. Like, that's just key. But staying out of the way is like, it's just basically not falling into like all the media shit and all the shit that come along with it. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what's gonna steer you into thinking certain things that you really shouldn't even be focused on like that. It's good to think about the world too. You know what I'm saying? And don't get me wrong, but at the same time, we got to get our mind and our mental right. You know what I mean?
How do you keep positive?
How do I stay positive? It's a lot to stay positive. First of all, we alive. Every day in this 24 hours, like, anything can happen. You know what I'm saying? You can get rich. You know what I'm saying? You can get married. You know, you can fall in love. You know, you can meet new people. Like, it's so many experiences that just come along with living that we don't even, like, take gratitude about. That's just what excites me. You know, it's like, it's a lot of positivity in that alone.
Twerk chicken.
They say the logo say chicken so good, make you want to twerk, so.
All right, how's the chicken, man? Does it make you want to twerk?
It does. And I brought my bougie friends here, and they were trying to be all dang on bougie when
they're
we got
being
the car.
Bougie, yeah.
But when we pulled up, we are not getting out of the car here. Oh, yes, you are. And now they are ordering food. The kitchen can't even keep up. They ordering so much dang on food. They tripping.
They're loving it.
They
it just
are.
Takes one experience. Now they're.
That's it. Now they hook. Now they twerking.
Can we? Oh, we get a twerk here. Can we get a twerk?
If you do a twerk, I'll do a twerk. Come on.
Today's video is sponsored by Roka News. Many of you ask where I get my news from. I go to many places for information, but one of my favorites is Roka News. Here's why. In today's divisive media landscape, it's hard to find news that isn't pushing an ideological narrative. I've found Roka News to be one of the best platforms for searching for truth away from political affiliation. They have an excellent Instagram page and daily newsletter. Both are good for people on the go with little time, but who still want to be up on some of the most important events of the day. On Instagram, check out their daily quick cards where they give bullet point briefs on 4 stories of the day, straight to the point and informative. And I strongly suggest their newsletter that goes a bit deeper into the stories. Links below here. So here's a great option away from the fear-based legacy media. Give Roka a try with my link below here in the description. Now back to the video.
All right, guys. This is one of those embarrassing moments, but here we go, bro. You're a cameraman. All
right. You got some music?
Dance to the beat, shuffle my feet, where's your time? Run with the kids.
Okay.
Can you give me some pro tips? What do I got to do? Hand up?
First of all, this is a competition. I'm not telling you what to do.
Look, hey.
Stretchy for twerking.
Nah, you can't look. Nah, hell nah. You gotta get your feet ready, bro.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And she ain't doing it right. Yeah.
I'm gonna twerk.
There you go. Go, Peter. Go ahead and turn that thing. Go one time.
Go, Peter.
Go, Peter. Hey.
Go, Peter.
Go, Peter. Go, Peter. Hey. Go, hey. Okay, Peter. Got Peter on the block turning up. What's up, my boy? Hello. Nah, we ain't gonna do all that. My boy got it.
Innovator.
So,
there we go.
Hey.
We twerking.
I'm out of breath.
Twerk chicken.
Hold up. Got that boy Peter on the block. They want to talk him out. So how we get out of the Turkey chicken, man.
It's my boy first time in Atlanta, you know what I'm saying? So came by the, you know what I'm saying, the Turkey chicken, you know what I'm saying? Because I already know y'all got anything going on.
So you're the owner of Twerk?
I'm on that Twerk chicken.
Who came up with the name?
I did. Twerk chicken. Chicken's so good, make you want to twerk.
Hey, I twerked before eating.
You did?
But is it usually eat the chicken, then twerk?
Eat the chicken, then twerk.
Okay, maybe I'll do both. Thanks, man.
Have a good one, buddy.
You too. All right.
Where we at? This is Kellen Road, Blood Area. I'm neighborhood, Rolling Sister Crip. So it's not about what you bang. It's not about a color. It's about your heart. And when you have heart and you stand on principles and morals, it takes you a long way. It sets you aside from the gang activity.
You're a Crip, but this is a Bloods hood.
Yeah, and I have love because I'm myself.
That's what I found interesting. In South Central, there's a lot of that intermixing too.
Acetylene, you got black onyx. You have labradorite for your immune system and bad anxiety. I've been shot in my stomach, so you know. I was the first one in my family to finish high school and go to college. To play ball for University of Arkansas, ranked number 5, come out of state of Georgia. I was most popular middle school, most popular high school, even in college, but I had the big head. The women, the drugs, me selling drugs, just the lifestyle. When I went through what I went through, I was on a colostomy bag for 3 years. Didn't know how much depression, stress that I had to deal with on my own, and I feel like God sent me through what I went through to humble myself, to figure out, to understand life. Life is bigger than me and you. Life is about setting up for the youth, the generation after us. So I feel like for parents that tell their children, you need to go to school, finish school, go to college, and get a job. No, right. Stop telling these kids that because of your dream is not their dream.
Okay. Yeah.
So why not, while the kids are in their teen, find out what they love, what they want to do.
Okay.
So you can find a way to pursue their dream.
Because you're only going to be great at what you really love.
You feel what I'm saying?
What you enjoy.
Stop being afraid to be yourself. If you're the cool guy, be the cool guy. If you're the nerd guy, you're the nerd guy.
What guy are you?
I'm the cool guy. I'm in between. Guess what? I don't have a point to prove. The message for today is know who you are and be your f***ing self.
21 Savage.
21 Savage. Mm-hmm. From here?
Mm-hmm. Greenwood Road, you hear him say that a lot.
This is very cool, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Massive market. Tell me about Gold Teeth.
Oh, you know, that's part of our culture, man. Gotta have some gold still, you know what I mean? Shout out to Scotty ATL, shout out to 80s Gold Grills, you know what I'm saying, for bringing like big highlights to the gold grill culture, you know what I'm saying? You should go get slugged out one time. You should go get you some tops and bottoms, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna watch you get slugged out. You feel me?
What do you guys think when you see BLM flags?
It's business, it's money, you know, just like United States. It's all business.
America just got a weird way of taking certain things and kind of flipping them into like corporations and shit like that. Where did all that money go to? That when people were donating all that money to Black Lives Matter.
Oh, you didn't see it at the street there? They have a new soccer camp, BLM soccer camp. You didn't see it?
Where did it?
Yeah, exactly.
Greenwood, yeah, right.
There's certain neighborhoods you guys just don't go to out of respect, or
yeah, they know what they're doing.
I respect the hood. I respect the hustle. So I never want to step into the area and slow down their money or whatever they got going on, because at the end of the day, it's really all around you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can give you history all day. You know what I'm saying? But you know, again, like my perspective of how I look at the hood and how they basically treat me. I always want to come across as somebody who's going to protect what they got going on at all costs.
All the bowling alleys in the hood, gone. Like, been gone for a good little minute. They got rid of them.
Why is that?
I can't really say. I wouldn't know. I was young. I used to just
go. Okay, they went a long time ago.
Yeah.
America to me like the Matrix, you know what I'm saying? Because it looks good, but you know, you gotta have a different type of eye to really be able to see what's really going on out here. Because like you said, you done been up all over the world, and you look at it, this area as if it's like, you know, like paradise, really. You know what I'm saying?
Right, like the infrastructure's good.
Yeah, the infrastructure's good. I don't want people to get caught up in the glitz and glamour when every area can get active.
You know what I'm saying? And what I mean by active is that, you know, it'd be crime going on.
I mean, it's some hoods right behind here.
With some Edgewood, little spots right behind here. Little hoods.
We gotta eat that food.
Oh yeah, we gotta eat that food. Downtown.
Here we go.
Test it out.
Twerk's chicken.
They say that they famous sauce.
They got their own sauce.
Very sweet, nice sweet sauce, yeah.
What do you guys think? Do you want it with good. Fries?
I remember the fries in order to get the sauce. Feel me, before to taste the sauce.
Sorry.
But for my first time experience, you know.
Very tender. I'm not really a wings dude because there's not much meat on the bun, but these are pretty good.
All right.
What is this?
We on Edgewood Avenue right now. MLK is on Auburn Avenue. Auburn Avenue is like right across from here. That's where Martin Luther King. Yeah.
It is on the
What do you got
video.
Going here?
I'm
what do you got going?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Officer says no.
What's going on? Frazier the Motivator, man. I got the books. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. We're doing Frazier something the Motivator.
Yes, yeah. Sir. Right here on the shirt. We're doing something positive for the community, for the kids, man. Affirmations. This is my book right here.
That's fire, bro.
Yes, sir. That's fire. A book and we got the workbook. We just out here making a difference in the world.
Good for you, man.
Yes, sir.
Good work, Frazier.
Hey, thank you so much. And whatever you're doing, keep being consistent. Keep doing your thing, bro.
Appreciate that, bro. No,
whatever you're doing, keep doing what you're doing. I appreciate the promotion because you didn't have to do that.
Nah, you all good. I had to make sure, bro.
Thank you.
You're doing something positive for the hood, bro. Yes, sir. Well, the neighborhood here. It's dealing with a little bit of gentrification because as you see, they're building this big building like right up here. So they tore down like, yeah, it's right over there. Like to me, they tore down Sound Table. They tore down, you know, little spots that like I'm used to hitting, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you got
to That's a little creepy.
Earlier, you was talking about basically a lot of the companies that's moving into Atlanta, right? And when they move into Atlanta, it's not like they're creating jobs for the people who live out here. They're bringing the people that work for them out here as well. So it's like they don't mind paying the high prices that come along. Like, not because they don't even look at it as being high because Atlanta really cheap. Rent really cheap. But now because a lot of big corporations are coming out here, the rent is going up and the people that are coming into the city, they paying the price because it's not cheap to them.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
What's the solution to that?
I mean,
that's a hard one.
It's a hard one because, I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, we also get opportunity, but it's just change. You know what I'm saying? And we got to be able to move along with the change. Shout out to the legendary department store, right?
This place?
Yes. It was a big hub for like creativity. It was a big hub for like Atlanta. We got Atlanta and then we got Atlanta. That's how I look at it. And that's really dealing with the creative crazy scene that we got. And this is one place where you'll be able to experience it every day of the week. It was open. But of course, again, since they take it from the culture, they shut it down. So, department store gonna be a real department store. It's not even gonna be a club.
Civil Rights Museum.
Yeah, so you can see a lot of things that's going on as far as, you know, real Atlanta culture. Martin Luther King's grave is actually right over there too. Surrounded by water, you know, rest in peace to King.
He's a true hero to you?
True hero, of course. Real Atlanta native, you know what I'm saying? Grew up out here, you know, and he used his voice and his position to basically put on for his beliefs. Atlanta dealt with a lot of segregation, we deal with a lot of racism, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So for him to be able to turn, you know, a negative experience into try to make a positive outcome, I can't do nothing but respect him for that. Where we at right now, a lot of shotgun houses. So you still seeing like that early Atlanta. So you still getting that real deal.
You call these shotgun houses?
These are shotgun houses.
What do you mean by that?
These are like little slavery homes.
Ah.
You see what I'm saying?
Those were slave homes.
Yes. Yes, 110%. Wow. And you can just be able to see, and I pray that we don't have to deal with them tearing down this area because to me, it's still a very historic area. And I don't want the only thing that's gonna be out here is gonna be Martin Luther King House, which is right here.
Which one?
The yellow house.
No way.
Yeah.
That's his home. He grew up in that home?
Grew up in that home.
Middle class dwelling.
Yeah.
Look how the middle class lived. That's very interesting. MLK was born here. Hats off to MLK.
For sure.
Beautiful home.
So
What a cool window.
As you can feel, like, the energy was, it was great. I felt empowered sitting up over there, you know what I mean?
Just right there.
I felt great.
Yeah.
I felt the energy.
He did so much for society.
Yeah.
1964 Civil Rights Act.
Yep. Try to, you know, spread some positivity out here. And that's all we can do as human beings, you know what I'm saying? Like, we all gonna have negative and positive outcomes. You know, we all humans, so we're gonna all have our different outlooks on, like,
right,
you know, the world and, you know, just like culture in general.
Is it easy just to say mutual respect? That's the solution to so much of this. Like, just respect whomever, no matter what background.
Yeah, it's all mutual respect. I think if we can just get there, you know, then I feel like we'll be able to, like, really recognize humanity for what it is. You know what I mean? Like, until you can respect somebody's culture, until you can respect where they come from,
yeah,
then it's like a lot of other things will make sense. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, Atlanta has just been having such a negative stigmatism dealing with a lot of the crime and a lot of other things that's going on, but not really realizing, like, this has become a melting pot for a lot of different places. And I mean, not a lot of different places, but a lot of different people from a lot of different cultures.
Mm-hmm.
And they're, it's like their first time kind of experiencing it.
Right.
And it's a shock to them because they never really... This wasn't on the pamphlet when you talk about Atlanta. They were like, they never experienced, like, the true nature of how it is out here. So
if you're to sum up the true nature of how it is, what is that?
The true nature
of Atlanta.
Hustlers. We out here hustling. We out here making shit happen.
Even though we just said, you said we had to go here.
Oh yeah, look. We had to go to Angelo Pizza. I don't care, bro. Best pizza, best wings you gonna get off of them up.
What are you guys barbecuing there?
Hamburgers, hot dogs, something.
Yeah, man.
Nice. Stoney's.
Put up a Stoney's, man. Shout out, man. It's just for the just a YouTube.
Shout out Town Real is in the field. Stoney's on the block, baby. We here.
Shout out to Stoney's, man.
Stoney's does haircuts?
Yeah. Come on, you bud. You know? Lots of ladies out here. You don't want to bother, leave them alone.
All right, guys, we're gonna have to cut this one right now because I'm on a plane in 3 hours with about 2 hours of driving through Atlanta traffic.
Through that traffic.
Maybe 2.5. So traffic. Thank you guys for bringing us in.
Yeah,
really
man.
Appreciate it.
Yeah,
and I also want to let you know that Kodak has an awesome Instagram page.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta check it out. I'll put the link down below. He's doing all sorts of cool things.
Good Atlanta history, man. Check
Atlanta
in.
Atlanta history.
Check in, man. The rarest, rawest history you're going to see. Not what you're going to see on TV, man. Only going to be able to see it here.
It's source. Kodak style.
Yes, for sure.
All right, guys. Thanks for coming along. Unique peek into Atlanta. I have two other videos on the city from completely different angles.
Yeah.
All right. Until the next one.